Kyrgyzstan Freemasonry has had a careful settlement for many years. And also in Uzbekistan and Turkmenistan, the Freemasonry does not leave the society alone in the same way that we do not leave the scene to them and strive with all we have to render their efforts void. There are many Masonic lodges there, so the Masons pressurize the Kyrgyz government. They occupy the key points in the state. They tell women to remove their headscarves, otherwise there will be unrest, so we'll have problems, they say. Also in the military, there are Masons, some high-ranking generals. Governments may be too weak to resist such pressure. Because there are Masons in the Kyrgyz government, three ministers are Masons, and such events are the natural consequence of that. Yet you can remove someone's headscarf and shave their hair, but you cannot eliminate their faith unless you scrape it off their brain. They have been organized there for many years, and in Uzbekistan too. They have arrested some Muslims and done other things, but they will not be able to stop the development for the Turkish Islamic Union, no matter what they do. For example, then the headscarf cannot be removed. Pressurizing Muslims, telling them not to read the book, burning the Quran will just enrage Muslims. They become exceedingly agitated. They committed oppression and savagery in Bosnia, but Islam spread like wildfire. They have now done that in Kyrgyzstan, and it will spread like wildfire there too. Everyone has woken up, and there is intense activity. And what has the headscarf got to do with it? What happens if you take their headscarves off? If you wear one, that is part of Sunni belief. The headscarf is part of Hanafi, Hanbali, Maliki and Shafi belief. But if you force them to remove their headscarf, you cannot take away someone's faith, and that person is not responsible for her action if you force her to do so.